You're watching PTS English News. I'm Stella Chu. First story today, the Hsinchu mayor election is heating up. KMT Hsinchu City Council Deputy Speaker Yu Bangyan showed support for TPP's candidate Gao Hongan, which led KMT supporters to wonder if the party is giving up on its Hsinchu mayoral candidate Lin Gengren. Meanwhile, Gao and DPP Hsinchu mayoral candidate Shen Huihong have a war of words over issues on transportation policy in Xiangshan District.
Hsinchu City Council Deputy Speaker Yu Bangyan from the KMT party led a group of borough chiefs to campaign for Taiwan People's Party Hsinchu mayoral candidate Gao Hongan during her rally last Saturday, November 19th. Yu again showed support towards Gao 2 days later with a post on his official Facebook. KMT supporters wonder if the party is giving up on its Hsinchu mayoral candidate Lin Gengren.
是我的议会同事，但对于他昨天表达的立场， 不但让支持者痛心和费解，也给对手分化我们的机会。我在此表达遗憾，但我仍然感谢这一阵子他的付出，也给予祝福。共同的目标就是下架民进党。我们不管多辛苦、多困难，绝对不会放弃任何一位同志。In
response to whether the KMT would penalize Yu, KMT chairperson Eric Zhu said the party would discuss it internally. On the other hand, Gao says she is grateful for any senior politician's support. As Election Day draws near, Gao and DPP Hsinchu mayoral candidate Shen Huihong continued confronting each other over issues on transportation policy in Xiangshan District of Hsinchu.
香山有史以来最大的中央补助经费 却在林智坚前市长，甚至我们现在已经看到资料里面，就是沈惠宏副市长当时担任是交通处长的时候，执意来去驳回，并且退回中央的经费。104年的时候呢，马政府车销还没有，所以我们新竹市政府只好暂时就配合暂缓推动，总经费42亿，当时
The DPP will be holding a final rally in Hsinchu on November 25th, and Shen invited all supporters to join. Meanwhile, Gao is still facing controversies with appropriating wages from her legislative assistants as internet celebrity 4X Cat Liu Yu exposed more inside stories to the media. Gao condemned all slander and said she may resort to taking legal action.
Well, now bringing some top stories from around the nation. An online scammer was recently arrested in southern Taiwan. He posed as a police officer and duped 8 women out of an estimated $3 million NT dollars over this past year. The Longxi District Office in Tainan recently cleared out an old marketplace building to invite vendors and convenience stores to open shops inside. The MOTC announced that train services traveling between Taipei and Taichung will resume on December 28th. Tickets for the New Year holiday period will be available starting December 2nd. Local elections will be held in Taiwan on November 26th, which is this Saturday. Experts are reminding the public to keep the masks on and refrain from unnecessary conversations with others to prevent the spread of COVID-19. Washing hands thoroughly after touching the ballots and stamps is also important.
Saturday, November 26th is Election Day. The government has stated that citizens reporting a positive test result from Monday 21st will not be allowed to vote on Saturday. Former Deputy Director General of the Centers for Disease Control, Shi Wen-yi, said there are bound to be many patients who will choose not to report to the government so they can vote. Those who have recovered for 3 months or more and have not received the next generation bivalent vaccine are recommended not to go vote on Saturday, Shi said.
要慎重的考虑，然后做好的保护，做好的评估。那最近会开始下架，很显然的，大家为了要去投票，很多人会投机取巧了。Some
health experts say that voting is a disciplined event. People will be wearing masks and keeping social distance. Taiwan's herd immunity level has reached 60%, so it is safe for most people to go back to living normally. Those with chronic conditions should remain careful, but there is no need for over-concern.
免疫缺乏的族群，有慢性病这些人，那我认为就是说这个部分，大家
要提高警觉，如果你已经打过次世代疫苗，你不用担心。如果你已经六月底以后感染的，包括 BA.2 跟 BA.5，也不必担心，因为有自然感染。
事情要看选举公报，知道自己要投给谁，这样现场才能够说投得干净利落啦，要赶快投完，赶快闪，赶快离开。那我想这样子就可以把感染的那个机会大幅的降低了。
Dr. Zhang Guanyu said people should remember to wash their hands after leaving the voting booth since they will be touching ballots and stamps. Also, the best advice is to keep conversations to a minimum. Voting booth arrangements and queue solutions are essential to lowering the risk for infection.
Under the government's COVID-19 quarantine policy, confirmed cases are not allowed to leave their residences, which would make voting impossible for people with COVID-19. Scholars and civil organizations think it's a breach on civil and political rights. However, the Taiwanese government insists on a $2 million NT heavy fine for confirmed COVID cases if they're found to break their mandatory quarantine and still go out to vote.
Whether people currently testing positive for COVID-19 are allowed to leave the house to go cast their ballots at the voting booth is one of the latest debate in Taiwan. Academician Chen Peizhe from Academia Sinica said prohibiting COVID-19 positive voters from voting in the November 26 local elections violates legally protected political rights. The government should provide Plan B for COVID patients instead of fining them heavily for going outdoors to vote. Chen suggested providing COVID patients with personal protective equipment to solve the problem.
已经有触犯宪法、违反宪法、保障人民选举权的一个状况啊，跟我们政府安排替代投票的方案哦，可以说是严重的延宕。我们可以设计前面一个小时的时间，让确诊者呢能够穿防护衣来进行投票。
比较担心会不会有隐匿确诊的问题，让民众不能投票，然后又有造成这个所谓的感染的问题。的确，要做这个决定都不简单。如果可以的话，我会支持客制化的帮他们做一个投票的一个动作。
For fear of later disputes and possible lawsuits, lawmakers from various parties all urged the Central Epidemic Command Center and related agencies to come up with a solution, since the election is less than a week away. CECC Commander Victor Wong replied, saying it is not easy teaching people how to wear PPE properly. Besides, it is crucial for COVID patients to remain in the house, Wong said.
不能离开居所，他自己去做什么是都不可以，并不是单纯只不让他投票。那你穿着隔离衣到投票所，对其他投票的人的心理上的影响或实质上影响又是什么？事实上，可行性不高了。
宪法23条，防止妨碍他人自由，那维护公共的这个秩序，本来就可以以法律定制的。
According to the current 5+N quarantine policy, people who have reported to be confirmed with COVID-19 on the 21st and beyond are not allowed to vote on the 26th.
And now some international news of the day. New Zealand Prime Minister said that her government would draft legislation for Parliament to discuss reducing the vote age to 16 after the country's highest court ruled that the current age limit was discriminatory. Two North Carolina turkeys escaped their Thanksgiving Day fate when U.S. President Joe Biden pardoned them in an annual White House tradition. A 5.6 magnitude earthquake killed more than 160 people and injured hundreds in Indonesia's West Java province on November 21st, with rescuers trying to reach survivors. Indonesian rescue workers are racing to reach people still trapped under rubble after an earthquake devastated a West Java town a day earlier, killing at least 162 people and injuring hundreds. Meanwhile, Taiwan's Ministry of Foreign Affairs says no Taiwanese have so far been found to be among the casualties. The Ministry of Foreign Affairs is sending its condolences and concern to Indonesia. Taiwan's representative office in Indonesia says there have been no reports of any casualties among Taiwanese nationals living in the country and will continue to monitor the situation to provide assistance to affected Taiwanese nationals. The 5.6 magnitude earthquake killed more than 160 people and wounded hundreds in Indonesia's West Java province on November 21st. The epicenter was in the town of Cianjur, about 75 kilometers southeast of the capital, Jakarta. Indonesia's disaster mitigation agency said 23 people were likely still trapped under the rubble of collapsed buildings. More than 2,200 houses were damaged and nearly 5,300 people have been displaced. Indonesia straddled the so-called Pacific Ring of Fire, a highly seismically active zone where different plates on the Earth's crust meet and create a large number of earthquakes and volcanoes. By law, ballots have to be transported to offshore islands 3 days before an election. Taitung County picked up its 800,000-plus ballots on the 22nd, and weather permitting, will transport them to Green Island and Lanyu on the 23rd. The Taitung Weather Station says the unstable weather that has plagued Taitung this past week should start improving on the 23rd. Due to a passing front, Taitung has been hit by torrential rains and big waves in the last few days. With 4 days remaining until the elections, will transportation between Taiwan proper and offshore islands be affected? In addition, how will ballots be transported back to Taiwan proper?
那尤其是在封面北台之后呢，在明天下半天之后，一直到25号、26号这个期间呢，它的天气是在越来越好的状态之下。
Weather conditions are expected to improve starting on the 23rd as the front moves away from Taitung and ballot transport shouldn't be affected. The Taitung County Election Commission picked up 800,000-plus ballots from the Central Election Commission on the 22nd. In accordance with Central Election Commission regulations, ballots must be transported to offshore islands at least 3 days before voters head to the polls. The Taitung County Election Commission plans to transport ballots to offshore islands on passenger ferries on the 23rd. If ferries can't sail, the Coast Guard will step in.
万一到礼拜三天气没有好转，我们的船不发，那我们绿岛跟兰屿的选票，那海巡署的舰艇队会派公务船来支援我们。
The Taitung County Election Commission says ballots will be flown in if weather makes marine transport impossible. Thanks for watching. We'll see you tomorrow. We'll be right back.